वेलकम अगेन टू प्लैनेट टू सोल एस्ट्रोलॉजी एंड टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द सीरीज ऑफ योग कारक प्लैनेट्स एंड टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट लिब्रा लग्न दैट इज तुला. सो तुला इज अ बैलेंस्ड साइन, मोस्ट बैलेंस्ड साइन. सो नेटिव हैविंग तुला लग्न और तुला मून साइन आर वेरी बैलेंस्ड पीपल इन देयर लाइफ. वाई बैलेंस्ड? Because the zodiac sign is indicated as weighing machine, tarazu. So they always behave in balanced manner in their life. This is a sign of Venus also. So people are very good looking of this lagna or of this zodiac sign. They are not very fair. They are having wheatish complexion. They are very polite speakers, and to a negative side, if we see, so they want means they are little dominating nature also. Many a times we see, if at all Surya is becoming powerful in this lagna or Chandra is becoming weak in this lagna, then they are too much of emotional people, and they feel bad of each and every moment of their life. If somebody speak like this, somebody spoke like this, but they recover also very fast because this lagna is of Tula. Even though they feel bad, they immediately recover themselves to become a good person, and they are very mingling person. They mingle with all, they talk good, and they are very helpful. So being a Lagnesh, Venus in Tula Lagna will fructify good to the native, but it's another zodiac comes in Earth Bhava. So Venus, if placed in 5th house or 9th house or in Lagna itself, it will fructify good to the native. But if it is placed in 8th house, even though in Swarashi, it may give less fruits in terms of marital bliss to the native. It may give property issues to the native. It may give late property or late house, if at all one want to buy. So many a things related to Earth Bhava we could see in this lagna. So second house belongs to Scorpio, that is a Mars sign, and Mars is also not enemy of Venus. So Mars in Libra Lagna is seventh lord also. So Marakstan again, and Markesh also, it becomes this Mars. But if it is placed with Lagnesh, that if it is placed with Venus, it will fructify good to the native in terms of domestic happiness, because if it is a male person, then very supporting wife, and if it is a female person, supporting husband, and both have good attraction power between them. The spouses have good attraction power between them to lead a happy marital life or to lead a happy life. Also, these people go in technical field, and if at all Mercury joins this combination or Mercury is with Venus, then they go in teaching profession also, they go in media, they go in creative line also, or such people are very creative also. So this was about Mars. Then we will go to third house. It is a Trishadiyadi Bhav, and the sign of Jupiter is placed here. The another sign of Jupiter comes in 6th house for Libra people. So both houses are not benefic houses for Jupiter. People become lazy if at all Jupiter is placed in 3rd house, or Jupiter wherever placed, this dasha for Libra people will not be so beneficiary. But as per other rules mentioned in BPHs and other our granthas, if at all this Jupiter is becoming auspicious or in own sign in Shadvarga or D9, it will fructify good to the native. If at all this Jupiter is placed in exalted sign, that is in 10th house in Karkata, then it will not fructify good to the native. We will say, oh, it is exalted. No, because being a lord of 6th and 3rd house, it is placed in Kendra, and Shubh planets whenever comes in Kendra, they lose their strength to give the fruits. Only Papa planets in Kendra will give good fruits to the native as compared to Shubh planets. So we have to consider this theory whenever we are assessing chart of Libra Lagna. But if this Jupiter is placed in Capricorn, that is in 4th house, the Jupiter Dasha will be favorable to the native in terms of household things, in terms of profession, because this Jupiter will aspect 10th house also. This Jupiter will aspect 8th house also, so hidden things or sudden gains are expected for this Lagna. Then we will go to 5th house. So there is a sign of Aquarius, and it is a Saturn. So Saturn for Libra Lagna is first yog karak planet, because the Saturn sign is in 4th house also, and Saturn sign is in 5th house also. See, one zodiac is in Kendra, another zodiac is in Trikona. So both are auspicious houses. So if Saturn is placed in these houses also, and otherwise also for Libra Lagna, Saturn is the best Shubh Karak planet. So whenever for Libra people Saturn Mahadasha will start of 19 years, it will give beneficiary fruits to the native. If at all this Saturn is placed badly in the chart, say if it is placed in 7th house, Nicha, if it is placed, then also this Saturn will give good fruits to the native in terms of marriage, partnership, but not as compared to exalted planet or other houses placed. If Saturn is placed in other houses than 7th Bhava, because 7th Bhava is Nicha Rashi, but here again we have to see the degrees. See, if it is in initial degrees, this Saturn will give good fruits to the native. Now this Saturn is first yog karak planet, and if at all Saturn is placed in 5th house or 4th house, or they have exchange of Lagnesh, means the Lagnesh Venus if is sitting in 4th house and Saturn is sitting in 5th house, then also it becomes one type of Raj Yoga. I remember one shloka from BPHS. It is said that Lakshmi Sthanam Trikonancham Vishnu Sthanam Cha Kendrakam Tayahi Sambandha Matrena Raj Yoga Dikam Bhave. That means any connection between Kendra Sthan and Trikon Sthan comes along, then it fructifies as a Raj Yoga. But as per experiences, as per other diktas, this Dasha Mahadasha has to come in one's life to fructify well. Now we will go to 6th house. There is a sign of Jupiter. We already discussed about it. 7th house is a sign of Mars, Aries. We discussed about it. It is not good planet for Libra Lagna. I mean to say, not Shubha planet or Yog Karak planet. Other than that, we have to see the placement of this Mars. Then we will come to 8th house. There is a sign of Venus again. We talked about it. Then we will go to 9th house, where there is a sign of Gemini, that is Mithuna. So Mithuna here becomes Shubha planet. Second Yog Karak planet in Tula Lagna is Mercury. Also it is a friend of Lagna. So whenever Venus and Mercury combination is formed in this Lagna, it will become Yog Karak. And if at all it is placed in 9th house, if it is placed in 5th house, or it is placed in Lagna, or if it is placed in fourth house also, it will definitely fructify good to the native person, will achieve good reputation in the society. Such people are creative people, they are fun loving people, and many a times I have observed that if at all good moon is there in the chart or moon combination with this planets come or its aspect come, they are very good cook. They are very good cook. Also, the chefs we see in hotel lines, also in big hotels also, they are having these combinations. Then we have to see Mars, Rahu, everything we have to see. Here, so first Yogkarak planet is Saturn. If at all Saturn is sitting with Venus also, so Saturn and Venus both are friend to each other, very good friends. So Saturn and Venus, you see, if at all placed in the chart, it will give tremendously good fruits to the native. And one who is following Jyotish, one who is a Jyotishacharya, or one who is into occult, if at all they are having this combination in their chart in D1 or D9, definitely they will earn good name, fame, and they will be having good Vak Siddhi in their chart, and people will remember them for long lasting years. Then we will come to 10th house. There is a sign of moon, Cancer sign. So moon is not Yogkarak planet for Tula Lagna. Moon will not fructify good to the native, but if this moon is in exalted sign in 8th house, again it will lose its strength. But if at all this moon is placed in 9th house, or this moon is placed in Aquarius sign, then these people are research oriented people, and they go for higher studies also. They go to foreign land also. If any connection of 3rd house, 5th house, 9th house and 12th house comes, then we will go to 11th house. There is a sign of Leo. There is a Singh. So again, Singh is not friend to Venus, but if this Yuti or if this combination is found in the chart, it will fructify say 50% good fruits native gets, because Lagnesh is placed with this Surya. But this combination will not give good marital bliss to the native, or native is somewhere somewhat the person is not satisfied in his or her life. So we have to see this also. Then we will go to 12th house. There is a sign of Virgo. So Mercury already we talked about, and if at all Mercury and Venus combination, it is said good. If there is a combination of Venus and 10th lord, that is moon, it is a good position. But we have found such people are very honest people. Whoever is having Venus and moon together in Libra Lagna, they are very honest people, and they work hard to achieve their goals. They don't run after getting anything. They always keep calm. They keep themselves away from any gossips. They keep themselves away from any controversies or something. So they are very balanced people. So we talked about the Yogkara planets of Libra Lagna, that is Saturn and Mercury, we have to take. And then we have to take the strength of each planet, nakshatras, and then we have to predict. But first thing you have to keep in mind, that this dasha, that is Venus, Saturn and Mercury dasha, is going to be good in these people's life, even though wherever these planets are placed. Now we will come to remedies. So what Libra people should do? Venus indicates goddess, Devi. So if at all Rahu or Ketu are placed with Venus, or if not placed with Venus, then also these people should always worship goddess. They have to help needy females, they have to help widow females, they have to help in education of children's, especially girls, they have to help. Then they have to recite Shri Suktam, they can do Durga Saptashati Patan, they have to visit goddess temple, they have to offer scented flowers, perfumes to Devi Ma, and they can praise Lord Saturn also, as it is a fifth lord. They can go to Vishnu temple also, as Mercury is ninth lord in the chart. Many remedies are there. You can take Lagnesh, you can take ninth lord, and you can take fifth lord to worship. So here I will conclude with Libra Lagna, and next time we will meet with Scorpio Lagna. So thanks for giving me so much of support, and thank you very much for subscribing my channel, and see you very soon. Bye bye. God bless you all. Thank you.